from Mondo Biondo, and this is the Mondo Biondo show.
And
how Biondo was your Mondo this week? Mine was bloody brilliant. I went to so many shows, so many openings, so many clubs. I had not slept in a week, but I look magnifico, no? Ah, si, si. And tonight I'm so excited because I find so many new performers for you. You're not gonna see this again on Hollywood Squares because the square is the last thing they are. These people are, come si dice, on the cutting edge. Oh, la, la. And you know, I'm so proud because this is what I live for. This is my cause. I scoured the globe looking for talent to open your middle-class eyes. You don't know it now, but you're going to love Mondo Biondo. So, the first film clip is ready, no? No? Si, si?
Yes.
No, no.
Yes.
Ah. Oh! Yes. Yes, no, people from London, England. I was there once. It was very cold. Greco people don't know what they're missing. Ah, they're such Philistines. They only care about making money. And they think to make money, you must have no taste and be a moral slime ball. But this is not true, because I, Mondo Biondo, am a living proof. You can be rich, 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 and still keep your artistic integrity. Look at me, I go where I want, I do what I want. Of course, you know, I don't need much. No, a little bread, a little hummus, a little baba ganoush. Where do you think I'm from? You know, I have not been in this country very long, but I'm doing well, eh? I have my own show on public access. I'm okay. This country is so strange. Last week, I got a card from somebody I don't know. It was a birthday card, but I was confused because it's not my birthday. This is the card. Happy birthday, Mondo. The gift I bear is not diamonds or silk, or a fabulous new eau de vie. It is instead this marvelous thought, you'll always be older than me. What does this mean? I'm not happy. I got an ultra letter, but I don't know where I put. Wait, I fa... Huh? Ah, si, si, si. My next performer is ready to roll. His name, Bill Irwin. Oh, he's such a sweet man. I love him to death.
Imagination, come on, everybody listen. Well, people all across the nation, who thinks they have imagination, say the ones to see you do.
Scusi, I found it. An old letter. I knew I got to last week. Let's see what this one says. Dear Mondo. Oh, he thinks I'm... Oh, he wants to... Roll the next paper. Paul is a loom. Oh, he's a very funny. He's a very funny. You're going to love him. Oh.
Mr. Saloon.
Hey, Jimmy.
That was a good show last night, Mr. Z.
Thanks, Jimmy. Yeah. See you later.
Break a leg, Mr. Z.
Thanks.
Places, Mr. Zaloon.
Thank you, Billy.
Ladies and gentlemen, eating in America. Last week, a group of yuppies went out to dinner.
You park the Volvo, we'll go inside. If you would park the Volvo, then we can go inside.
Toc, 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 toc. Bonsoir, monsieur, dame, can I help you?
We are hungry, we are hungry.
Oh, d'accord, do you have reservation?
Reservation, reservation, no, 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 no.
Oh, I'm sorry, we don't have table for 2 hours.
2 hours? What was that? 2 hours? I'm gonna...
Mistake, we have table. Come this way, please.
We are happy, we are happy.
Okay, your waiter will be here in 1 minute.
We are thirsty, we are thirsty.
Oh, d'accord. Glug, 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 glug. Tuck, 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 tuck.
Scrubble, 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 scrubble.
Hi, I'm George, and I'm your waiter for this evening.
We are hungry, we are hungry.
Yes, well, I'm sure you are. Now, for our appetizer this evening, we've distilled French cooking to its bare essence with a giant pat of butter.
Hi, I'm Pat, and I'm your butter for this evening.
Butter, 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 munch, 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 butter, 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 munch, munch, munch.
Now, for our main course, we have a lovely quiche Lorraine.
Keys, 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 munch, munch, munch.
And a delicious salmon mousse.
Scrubble, 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 scrubble. Tuck, 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 tuck. I hope everything is satisfactory.
Very good, very good, very good, very good, mediocre.
I am hungry, I am hungry, I am hungry.
No, please, we don't have food for you. And besides, you're not properly dressed. Oh, please, go out.
We are thirsty, we are thirsty.
Oh, d'accord. Glug, 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 glug.
All right, for dessert this evening, we have pear a la Hitchcock.
Good evening. My name is Alfred Hitchcock, and I am your pear for this evening.
Psycho the birds, vertigo, munch, munch, munch. Psycho the birds, vertigo, munch, munch, munch. We are thirsty, we are thirsty.
Oh, d'accord.
Glug, 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 glug.
Tuck, 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 tuck.
We are drunk, we are drunk.
Hey, wow, let's take off our shoes. Yeah, we. Hey, let's see if we can stand up. Oh, shit, we can't. Hey, wow, let's make a pyramid. Yeah, wow, this is fun, just like college. Yeah.
Tuck, 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 tuck. No, please, stop this behavior. Stop this immediate moment, my restaurant.
We are sorry, we are sorry. We are professionals, we are professionals.
Okay, here is your check. The fight over the check.
I'll get it. No, I'll get it. No, allow me. No, allow me. I'll get it. I'll, oh, my heart. Oh, my heart.
Oh, merde. I must call an ambulance.
Well, maitre d', call an ambulance.
And the ambulance came and took the young man to the hospital where doctors put him on a heart monitoring machine. And this is what the doctors saw.
How's it look, Doc?
Not too good, Doc.
Oh, look at that left ventricle.
Yeah, pretty clogged.
Uh-oh, irregular heartbeat. Uh-oh, stat, cardiac arrest, stat, nurse, stat.
How you doing? Yeah. Love that pink stuff.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Pa! Pavia! That was my... My beauty SWAT team. Scusi. Oh, that Paul Zaloom is so good, so funny, and he makes me so hungry. That's why tonight I'm going to talk to you about the latest food craze sweeping the country. I'm talking about wheat grass. So good for you, but so hard to stomach, eh? Now, my cameraman, Eddie, his wife, is into the wheatgrass business. That's why I happen to have this little flat here tonight. I know you, my listening audience, you don't know your grass from your elbow. So tonight I'm going to show you how to extract juice from this miracle weed. First, you take scissors, give a big haircut, toss in the juicer, just the green part, eh? Turn on. It's no work. Oh, it's not plugged in. Where's the outlet, eh?
What? It's behind you. It's behind you, Mom.
I don't see. Hey, where's the outlet? See. Ah, excuse. Ah! See, here it is. Here it is.
No!
Ay, yay! What do we always do? Blind! Roll the next step! Petalesco! The fabulous Petalesco!
We have recently received a report from one of our most prestigious scientific institutions, the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, that advises factory workers protect themselves from nuclear attack by jumping into large pools of water wearing as much clothing as possible. The laboratory recommends that this procedure be practiced by employees in the workplace to adequately prepare themselves for post-nuclear survivability. We would be insincere in denying that the thought of thousands of well-wrapped workers bobbing up and down and up and down in the factory swimming pool has its humorous aspect. The report also recommends diving about 4 feet down and spending as little time as possible at the surface for air. That should be easy if you're wearing long underwear, 3 sweaters, 2 winter coats, and a muffler. The difficulty we foresee is getting to the surface at all. Armageddon. Why not even Don Quixote would voluntarily attempt swimming to safety when he was dressed to kill?
She is so profound. I am having an emotional meltdown. You know, when we watched this film together, she said to me, Mondo, you know, this one going to give them a kick in the pants. And I know what she means. Such a perspective and such an unusual fashion statement. I, Mondo Biondo, I love the unusual in the fashion statement, which is why I have invited my next guest. Her name is Suzanne Barge, and she is totally wigged out. Darling, so good to see you. Don't tell me that is a wig.
You should know, darling.
Ha, it looks exactly
does
like
it really?
It does. Ah, bravo, bravo. Suzanne,
I'm so sorry we have no more time.
Sorry, I'll lend it to you anytime.
Mille grazie to you for coming. Our next film clip, The Mesmerizing Mr. David Cale. Girlfriend, you go back.
I always had this fascination for things that could fly. Things that could just move around in the sky without holding on to anything. Some birds move the whole way around the world. That kind of freedom. To just go wherever you wanted. And if you got tired of where you were, you just go back up in the sky. Find somewhere else. I've always envied birds. I was flying through the sky. In a Freddie Laker plane. I was thinking to myself, I'm never going to go back to that country again. I had one small bag with me. It contained a selection of my favorite clothes. I was looking out the window. I had my little Olympus in my hand. I was taking snapshots. Of clouds. A tall lady in a uniform was renting headsets. She had little bird wings on her shoulders and Laker Airways ran on her breasts. She reminded me of Karen Black in Airport 75. And I thought, wonder if she could land a sky train. I gave her $3 and she gave me a headset. So I plugged myself into the armrest and I got John Denver in my head and he was saying, take me home, country roads, take me home, almost heaven. Then Karen Black came back and she said, would you like crabs or would you prefer the beef? And I said, I don't eat meat. And she swiveled around and produced a plate of food specifically for people who don't eat animals. I'm not sure what it was, but it was very colorful. When I'd finished, she took away the tray. Was that okay? What was it? Reality is something you rise above. That's why I work up here in the sky. Then the lights went out and little screens came down. And on the little screens was a little movie about a mountain climber who sings. A singing mountain climber. Every time he climbed a new mountain, he'd sing about it. And I thought, unusual film. I recognize those eyes, the way that mouth moves, those ill-fitting teeth. That's no mountain climber, that's me. But that's not my voice. I've been dubbed. I shout to the woman next to me. I've been dubbed. But the woman leans across and says, that's your voice, honey. It's just you've never heard it before. It'll take some getting used to. It's a funny voice. Don't ever be afraid of your funny voice. Then the other passengers started singing along. Singing along with the screen. The whole flight in harmony. It's just like when my grandmother used to go on coach trips to the Cotswolds. Out of the blue, she'd start singing Onward Christian Soldiers. I'd get embarrassed, but everybody on the coach would sing along and unite.
and love each other. My grandmother's singing made people forget for a moment they were full of fear and distrust. Now my singing is doing the same thing. And I look out the window, and there's this huge flock of Carolina wood duck. And I shout to the woman next to me, look, wood duck. You don't get wood duck in Europe. Wood duck are American birds, birds of North America. I've shifted continents. I'm in another stratosphere. And the wood duck are looking at us because they've never seen a plane full of singing people. And I leap to my feet and I start yelling. I'm going to take my life in my hands and shake it and shake till all the bad parts fall out, till they've all dropped out of me like dead leaves shaking from a living tree. There they go, all those rotting leaves, there they go. I'll shake and shake till only the living, the present, the alive is left. No dead leaves, no past. I'll shake up the past. Let the past get past. Let the past get past. And I realize I'm saying what I feel, doing what I want. I get nervous again. I'm afraid of what I might want to do. I'm scared of what will come out of my mouth. But I can't stop. I'm being taken over by me. The me I haven't been yet. The me I'm going to be when I start being myself. The frightened, the angry, the me that got buried in the childhood. All of the me's are all out at once. All acting and singing, asserting, saying, let's see where the future can go. Let's see where the future can go. Then applause. Cheers. Clapping passengers. I'm a hit. Karen Black comes out of the cockpit.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm just about ready to hit the ground. Safety belts belted. Extinguished cigarettes. Luggage where it should be. We're coming into land. Any minute now, we're gonna be landing. Build yourself a life and live with it. Coming into land, any minute now. Coming into land, any minute now. Coming into land, any minute now. Welcome to America.
David Kelly is so moving. That's why, you see, it makes you ponder, ponder, ponder again. That's why this is art, because it makes you think. My next guest is coming to our studio live. At least I think she's alive. She wrote me a letter last week. So touching. She wants to sing on my show. So here she is singing one of Jeanette McDonald's favorite songs, Eudora P. Quickly. Eudora.
There's a little brown road winding over the hill to a little white cart by the sea. There's a little green again.
Well, she was beyond the beyond. Still, I get a little tear in my eye. The part, you know, all those two eyes of blue shining through, very sweet, eh? You know, before I was on public access, I was una grande scrittore at Cinecittà. But even there, I never see such poetry, such colore, such originality as here tonight. My next group on the film clip, they should be called Poetry in Motion, but instead they're called La 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 Human Steps. Scusi. Ah, la la la, only three lines? Right. Ah, si, si. La la la, Human Steps.
These kids are amazing. They fling themselves. Oh, such a commitment. Oh, tonight we are swimming in talent. Eh? E che cosa fai? Che fai vento? Who's break the wind, eh? Why don't you tell me? Who is it? Eddie. Eddie, is that you? I got to find out for myself. Che fai vento? Oh, cut the cheese! Oh, this noise is making me nuts. Because I am very sensitive. Oh, it's coming from the main room. Why, I've never been in the main room. I must go see. What's going on?
Have you noticed that your balls are turning blue? That's why I say, neighbor, hey, neighbor, you know what to do? Put your hand in this around you, it's a dying
man. You find a happy catch and you finally try. But I'm not going to make your way back. Hey, neighbor, let me do.
Shine on, shine on the harvest moon. Up in the sky.
Yeah.
Those boys, they are so bizarre and yet so wonderful. Hey, what a night for Mondo. Wasn't I a fabulous host? I tell you, I loved everybody. But now all good things must come to an end. So now it is time for me to say, ciao, bambini! And I hope you had a most fabulous time, because I did. And I hope you got your brain cells jumping and pumping for joy, because mine were. Do me a favor, go make pee-pee, go make a pizza, but before you do, call up the station, tell them you want to hear more, 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 more of Mondo. That's me,
Mondo Biondo.
I'm Mondo. Aye, aye.
Mondo Biondo.
Listen to me. Sometimes I go uptown to go shopping, you know, and those filthy yuppie couples give me such bad vibes. But hey, I am proud to be on a public access, and I hope you will continue to subscribe to Mondo, Eddie Shooter the Field.